labor to try to find that sense of peace, that sense of security. But we already heard his word. He's already invited us. Some of you, you've been longing to experience the presence of God. You've been longing to have an encounter with God. But if you would, just in this moment, lift your hands one more time. I want you to know that our Father is here. He knows everything. There's nothing that happens in your world that catches him by surprise. He sees every tear. He sees every night up worrying, pacing the floor, crying out to him for his presence. Some of you just want him, just show me that you're real. I need you. But I want you to know that your Father is here to embrace you in this moment, to take away every fear and every concern. All you have to do is ask him. Wrap me in your talk to your Father.
Good morning to each and everyone. Remember, the program is Light in My World. This is Victoria Miller. Keep it locked to Stars FM. Don't move the dial an inch. Three wonderful lineup segment for you this morning, all Massive and Crew listening live to Stars FM Radio. Indeed, we are in the hour now of praise and worship. After this, we ask that you send your prayer requests, or now you can go ahead with your text and call for your prayer requests, after which we have the word. Caller, good morning.
Morning.
You need to turn down your radio and move away from it.
Morning.
How are you?
Happy New Year to you, darling.
Same to you, sweetie.
I'd like to pray for my grandmother and my aunt in England.
Grandmother and aunt?
Yes. For a car from Portland, Gurney.
Okay.
And Martin Ward. And Claudette Pockybon.
Okay, Claudette, so you said pray for your grandmother and your aunt, you say?
Yes.
All right.
My name is Janet.
All right.
Thank you.
Show me your face. I want to see you. I want to see your glory. And I want to live in the secret place. Show me your face.
Number to reach us is 453-1444. Yes, indeed. If you are calling us from the United Kingdom, from the US or Canada, the number is 954-338-7973. That's 954-338-7973. That's a toll-free number for the US and Canada. If you're in the USA and you want to have us live on your cell phone, you can dial 213-992-4360. That's 213-992-4360. Or if you're in the United Kingdom and you want to have us live on your cell phone, you can dial 033-0010-3322.
I know this is where a lot of...
That's 033-0010-3322. You can call or text the studio here at 453-1444. So as I said, we are in the hour of praise and worship. At this time, you are allowed to call in with our text in your prayer requests. You know that any time after 7:30, we are finished with prayer requests. You can't send no more that you're going to hear read, so make sure you're getting them in right now. Indeed, we want to touch and agree with you and see heaven culture displaying in your life. So we are here to do just that and more. Call us with your prayer requests so we can agree. It is the King who bid all men to pray and faint not. So, your way of communicating with heaven is through prayer. And so, as a citizen of the kingdom, yes, I stand representing you, your situation. What is it that you can't go through? What is it that is so impossible? What is it that is plaguing you that you can't do anything about? Surely, there is no barrier when it comes on to heaven doing something in an earthling's life. Yes, he can touch your situation. Heaven can touch your concern this morning. And so I invite you to give it to God.
Show me your face. I want to see.
And this one's a good morning, sister. Please pray for Winsome and family.
I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. I give myself away so you can. Come on, let him know. I give myself.
Are you ready to give self away to the King of Kings? You see, giving self to the King is he's the only one who deserve it and really deserve it, because what? It is he who have made us. Then if he is the one who made us, and remember in his word he said he wish above all that we prosper and be in good health. Yes, then who is the better person to give self to this morning? So many of you are aching even now to have certain people in your life But have you stopped to think about your purpose? Why did the king place you on planet Earth? Why don't you go back to the source that gets you in the earth in the first place and give self away to him so that he can lead your life into that purpose that he creates you for? You see, nobody knows it better than him, not even you. So can we give self away this morning? Oh, give myself away. Paula, good morning, you're live.
Good morning, Miss Victoria.
How are you?
I'm okay so far. What about you?
I'm good, you know.
Okay, thank God for that. Okay, I'm asking a please to pray for my family, the Kate family, please.
Okay, the Kate family.
Yes.
All right, sweetheart, thanks for calling.
Okay. No problem, all right, thanks very much.
If you just try to get me just now on my cell phone, I'm going to ask you to call again. Can you declare it this morning that your life don't belong to you? Can you just give self and just release yourself from all the stress about you? You see, when you give self to the King of Kings, then you don't have to worry about self because you have given over. You see, that is our biggest problem today. We are stressing over ourselves, over all our concerns. But if we can truly give ourselves into the hands of the King, then he's responsible for us. He's the one who has our back when we give ourselves to him. But he won't take it from you. You have to give it to him. This was a good morning to you, Sister Victoria, and to Blessings. Jerome, big up yourself. Paula. Good morning, your life.
Good morning, sister.
How are you, ma'am?
Please, I'm all right. Please, I'm asking help to my family.
What is your...
Isoline.
Isoline. All right, Isoline.
Come on, worship. Open your mouth and begin to speak to him. Come on, open your mouth and let the spirits begin to flow out of you.
My heart. Caller, you're live. Good morning. Go ahead, sweetheart. Say good morning to baby Janelle and mommy and son. This one say good morning. Please pray for me. I am not feeling well in my body. Carmen. Can we declare the Lordship of Jesus Christ right now? Father, I declare you Lord and King forever, and I want you to reign. Holy Spirit, I release you to rule and reign in these situations. Caller, you're live. Good morning.
Good morning, Sister Victoria.
How are you today, ma'am?
I'm good.
Wonderful.
Yes, I'm asking you for prayers.
Okay.
And hope you all the best and serve the friend, respect.
Okay, give me your name before you leave.
Blossom.
Blossom. All right, Sister Blossom, you take care.
You take care.
Can we just say yes? You see, if you know say everything about you after the king, make me hear you sing that one, you know?
Somebody begin to praise the Lord tonight. Somebody begin to give it over to God tonight. Give him your heart, give him your mind, give him your soul. Give him your will. Let go of your emotions. Let go of the pain. Let go of the stress. Let go of depression.
Clear that back to you one more time.
Let go. Your hands and just worship him. He deserves the glory. He deserves the honor. Come on, worship. Open your mouth and begin to speak to him. Come on, open your mouth and let the spirits begin to flow out of you.
My heart, my mind, my soul. Yeah.
Caller, you're live. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you today, ma'am?
I'm doing. I'm doing so prayer this morning for my surrounding, Jillian.
Okay, Jillian, so you need prayer for your surrounding?
Yes.
All right, sweetie.
Thank you.
If you have been blessed by this ministry, we would like to give you the opportunity to partner with us and help us in sharing the cost to win the loss. To send your gift or offering, please call us at 583-4479 or email us at vsharpmiller@gmail.com.
Are you thinking of a place, extraordinary place, where you can get a wide variety of Jamaican cuisine, scrumptious local dishes, and at the most affordable price? Come to think of it, there is such a place, Zilla's Kitchen. For breakfast, lunch, and dinner, they use only natural herbs and spices, and of course, they've met all health standards with a friendly staff certified by the Board of Health. So if it's home cooking you want in a safe sanitary environment, Zilla's Kitchen is the place to eat. We're located at Bridge Street, Port Antonio. And for takeout service, contact us at 453-6030.
In my royal ministry with Sister Victoria. Yes, the little head with the big voice. In cooperation with Ken presents a kingdom explosion with a royal gathering of the sons of God. Come sail away with us on a 4-day cruise to the Bahamas. From June the 6th to the 9th, 2016, where we will share in this event the message of the kingdom of God. For more information, just contact 583-4479 or 852-3611. For further details, call now. The spots are going.
Hi, this is Vonsil Belcher, and you're listening to Styles 96.1, 96.7, the People Station with Victoria Miller.
Sister Vicky, you know, Sister Chicken come for trick way. Right now, we are send it back to the pit of hell with light in my roll on 96.1 FM. Sister Victoria, SSBG representing.
Losing a loved one can be a very difficult experience. At St. George's Funeral Home, we try to ease that burden. We offer 24-hour pickup island-wide, airport pickups and drop-offs, gospel bands, grief counseling, funeral clothing and accessories, headstones, custom and personalized packages. Visit us at 24 West Street, Port Antonio, and 22 St. George Street, Buff Bay, Portland. Call us at 913-6450 or 841-3117 and 715-4058. From the USA, Canada, and the UK, toll free 347-377-8126. Like us on Facebook, St. George's Funeral Home, or email us at stgeorgesfunhome@hotmail.com. St. George's Funeral Home, thoughtful and caring service when you need it most.
You can't afford to miss it. The Road to Glory, your Sunday morning gospel and inspirational music program on Styles 96.1 from 9 a.m. until 12 noon. Tune in. Styles, the People Station.
Your hands and just worship him. He deserves the glory. He deserves the honor.
Yeah, these are the solution for all our stress. Especially if you say you're born again and you have some problem, this is what you need to do. You need to know this. You see, if you take your situation for yourself and in the kingdom, it can't work for you. It all belongs to remember in that word, he said, look here, no worry about nothing. You. No worry about nothing, but seek my kingdom. Hey, hey. So anytime you find yourself and worry about some things, it means you take over your life. You become responsible for yourself. But in the kingdom, you are not responsible for yourself. The king is.
Sing it with me.
And if you give yourself to the king, he's the one who have your back. It doesn't matter what it looks like. By faith, you have to believe it. You're not living by sight. You live by what you know, what you believe, what you're confident the king to do. So do a situation did and they look bad. Nevertheless, you walk by faith and you know that God, I am not going to believe what I'm seeing. I'm not going to believe what I'm feeling. I'm not even going to believe what I'm hearing. I'm going to trust in you because your word says, and if your word says this about me, King, you are not a man that you should lie. I'm going to put your word to the test. And trust me, he is faithful and just. There's no way you can believe in God and confident him to take care of you and he don't. God is not a man that he should lie. If you can believe his word about your life, then you can see fulfillment coming out of that kingdom. So here when me I tell everybody I know, believe God. Yes, it does. Because me believe him, here when me I have to declare about myself. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. And every tongue that rises against me in judgment, guess what? I condemn them. I am established in righteousness and oppression is far from me. The weapon of my warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. I take the shield of faith and I quench every fiery dart of the enemy. I take the sword of the spirit, which is the word of God, and I use it against the enemy. I'm teaching someone how to fight. I am redeemed from the curse of the law. I am redeemed from poverty. I am redeemed from sickness. I am redeemed from spiritual debt. I overcome all because greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. I stand in the evil day, having my line girded about with truth, and I have the breastplate of righteousness. My feet are shod with the gospel of peace. I take the shield of faith, and I am covered with the helmet of salvation. I use the sword of the spirit, which is the word of God. I am delivered from the power of darkness and translated in the kingdom of God's dear son. I tread upon serpent and scorpion over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall hurt me. I do not have the spirit of fear, but power, love, and a sound mind. I am blessed with all spiritual blessing in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. I am healed by the stripes of Jesus. My hand is upon the neck of my enemies. You anointed my head with oil. My cup runs over. Goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. I am anointed to preach, to teach, to heal, and to cast out devils. I receive abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness. And I reign in life through Christ Jesus. I have life and that more abundantly. I walk in the light as he's in the light, and the blood of Jesus cleanses me from all sin. I am the righteousness of God in Christ. I am the head and not the tail. I shall decree a thing and it shall be established in my life. I have favor with God and with man. Wealth and riches are in my house, and my righteousness endures forever. I will be satisfied with long life, and God will show me his salvation. I dwell in the secret place of the Most High, and I abide under the shadow of the Almighty. No evil will befall me, and no plague shall come near my dwelling. No, we want Jamaica to declare this. No evil will befall us, and no plague. The plague that is out there, the disease that is out there that can be catched by a mosquito, that can we declare the Lordship of Jesus Christ this morning, that no evil will befall us and no plague shall come near our dwelling. My children are taught of the Lord, and great is their peace. I am strengthened with might by spirit in the inner man. I am rooted and grounded in love. I bless my natural enemies, and I overcome evil with good. This one says, good morning, Sister V. Special good morning to you, Mr. Spence and Mrs. Hunter from Marlene. Bless you, Marlene. Thanks for writing.
Not the form of godliness, but be holy as he is holy.
Well, I say good morning to Mr. Spence over there in Canada. Of course, big up yourself. I know you're listening. I want to say good morning to Marlene Hunter down there in Spring Garden. Also want to say good morning to Denise. I haven't heard from her for a long time, but I want to big her up same way. Mm-hmm. Want to say good morning to Marlene in Canada, Sharon, and all you wonderful people who continue to listen to the Word of God from time to time. Want to say good morning to Claudette. Yes, all of you wonderful peeps. There are some persons that text me about the cruise. Are you going? What are you saying? Let me have your discount. Let me have your deposit amount so I can put it in. Yes, send it in now. Good morning, good morning. Caller, you're live.
Good morning, Sister Vicker.
How are you today, sir?
I'm all right. I'm asking you to please. Continue to pray for me and my sister, Marcia Dennis, please.
What is your name again, sir?
My name is Barrington. I'm New Island girl.
Barrington and your sister, yes, sir?
Yeah, and my auntie. I live with my auntie. God bless you. Continue your good work, please.
All right, Mr. Barrington, I'll pray.
Okay.
Okay.
Stop.
Can we declare him holy this morning?
Only you are worthy. Only you are wonderful, Lord God. Only you are wonderful.
Father, we lift up your name. There is no one else like you this morning, great King. You alone are God. You alone are King. And so we announce it in the atmosphere that only you and you alone. And everything about me testify of your goodness, great King. All my love, my life, my heart is a testimony of your goodness. Can we declare it in the atmosphere around us? Hallelujah! 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 Can we praise the King of Kings this morning? Can we worship him like never before? Can we give him a never before worship? Can we give him a never before praise? There's no one else like you. My heart, my life is a test.
Only you are holy.
Only you are whole.
Father, because you alone are worthy this morning, we honor your name.
Only you. I
want to say good morning to Balfour and Stephanie in Norwich. Good morning, Maffey. Good morning, Mr. Miller. Wherever you may be this morning listening and you're hearing my voice, good morning. Mr. Danny up there in Berrydale, bless up yourself. All Massive and crew listening from the eastern point of Portland, Manchineel, Long Road, wherever you may be this morning in those region, this is coming from me, Styles FM crew, and everybody here in Styles, good morning. Can we declare the Lordship of Jesus Christ now? Father, we declare him King forever and ever, God. For you are holy. You are holy. Caller, good morning. You're live.
Good morning, Sister Victoria.
Oh, you do, sweetie?
I'm not too bad. Remember Michael with the wounded eye?
Michael with the eye, yes.
Yeah, I'm not wounded anymore. I'm just going to church back again.
Bless you, brother. Bless you. Good to hear.
Yeah. I want you to pray for me and my wife.
Okay.
And my son and my daughter.
All right, Michael.
And my father, Samuel Moore, in Shrewsbury, Commodore, and my sister, Davina and Jasmine.
Okay, so it's Michael and the family.
Yeah.
Bless up yourself, Michael. Continue to keep it locked to Styles and believe God.
Okay. That's good.
Can we declare him? Father, we lift up your precious name this morning because you alone are God. You alone are King. Righteous altogether you are and just, faithful, wonderful, holy God. We bless you today. We magnify your great name, Almighty God. We place you in the highest place this morning. You are forever God. You are forever King. There is no one else like you. And so we give you worship, God. We bless you, Almighty God. We thank you, Almighty God. We hail you, King. We worship and adore you this morning, Almighty God. Because you are holy. You are holy. You are set apart. You are one with yourself. There is no other God like you, Almighty God. You're in a class by yourself this morning. And so for this, we give you praise. We give you honor. We give you glory, great King of Kings. Hallelujah. Father God, I come before you this morning having an understanding of who I represent in this place this morning. And so, King, I release you. Holy Spirit, I release you into the atmosphere. I release you right now to rule and to reign in this place today. Yes, God, let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven today. Hallelujah. Father God, I release your awesomeness. I release your greatness. I release your peace to the massive, to the crews, to all who are listening this morning. I release your Holy Spirit to take full control in the name of Jesus Christ the King. And so, Father God, I lift up that aunt and that grandmother in England right now, God. I superimpose your lordship over those lives this morning. And I thank you, Almighty God, as your order filled their lives. Father God, we know that your order cannot come into their life and their life remain the same. And so right now, Holy Spirit, I release your order into England in those people's life. In Jesus' name. Father, I release your order into Winsome and family's life today. everything that beset them, everything that is against them. I release your presence. I release the blood of Jesus. I release the King of Glory. I release the Lord of Hosts to fight on their behalf today. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I pray when you will bring stability to their lives. I pray when you will bring stability to this family. In Jesus' name. And in the same breath, God, I lift up the Cage family to you. Father, you know everything that there is to know about them. You know them by name. You know them by number. You know the situation. You know the circumstances. But in the name of Christ the King, we superimpose the order of God now in the life of the kids. In Jesus' name. And Father, we thank you, God, as you correct. My God, we thank you, Almighty God, as you bring order into every situation. We thank you, God, as you allow yourself to be magnified in these lives. Father, we bless you today for the life of the Cates family. In Jesus' name. Father, we lift up Dwight with a mental problem. We lift up Errol and we lift up Mother Thompson to you. Father God, she's a mother, and you hear her cry where her situation is concerned. My God, mental problem is no problem to heaven culture. Because when the kingdom of God was here in the earth, demonstrating through Jesus Christ, we see him heal the lunatics. We see him heal the people who is demon possessed. We see him, Almighty God, opening the ears of the blind and the deaf and the dumb. And all these people, these things did not challenge Jesus. And so therefore, Almighty God, as a representative in the earth, I release your order upon this mental situation with Dwight. Father God, we claim Dwight for your kingdom today. Father God, we release the order of God around his mind. We release the mind of Christ to him through the power of the blood of Jesus Christ this morning. We superimpose stableness and sober mind to his mind right now. In Jesus' name. And we command the mental disorder to desist. In the name of Christ the King. We reverse you today. We shut you down today. We claim Dwight for the kingdom of God. In Jesus' name. And Father, we thank you as you bring healing, as you bring deliverance to Errol and the mother today, God. We pray, Almighty God, for every need being met. We pray, Almighty God, that you will have mercy upon them. We release the blood of Jesus on their behalf to fight for them, Almighty God. And we thank you for stableness coming into his mind. In Jesus' name. Yes, God, in the same breath, we lift up Iselin and family. And Father, we thank you, Almighty God, for your order coming into his her life continually as she continued to ask for prayer each Sunday morning. God, I know that it's not in vain because you hear and you answer and you're a God of purpose. And so whatsoever you would purpose in this family, God, I pray when you will bring it to pass in the name of Christ the King this morning. I superimpose your righteousness over this family. I superimpose your order. I superimpose the blood of Jesus. And I thank you, Almighty God, as you reconcile them back to you. In Jesus' name. Father, I lift up Carmen today in prayer. And I thank you, Almighty God, that you know her by name. You know everything that there is to be known about Carmen. Nothing about Carmen takes you by surprise, Holy Spirit. And so right now, Almighty God, I loose the Holy Spirit in the life of Carmen to bring stability, to bring clarity, to bring peace, to bring order. In Jesus' name, everything that besets her, Almighty God, everything that wear down this morning, Father God, we speak peace, we speak freedom, we speak peace and wholeness in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth in the life of Carmen. And we thank you this morning, Almighty God, as you uphold her. We thank you this morning for your blood fighting for her. We thank you this morning, Almighty God, as you deliver her. We thank you this morning, Almighty God, as you change her life forever. Hallelujah. Father, we lift up Blossom with whatever is going on in her life today. We lift up Blossom today, Almighty God. And we thank you, Almighty God, as you continue, Almighty God, to work in the life of Blossom because she's your workmanship. And so this morning, Father, we thank you as you allow your peace and order to be fully in her life. In Jesus' name, in the same breath, Father, we lift up Julian. And she talks about her surrounding. Whatever is in Julian's surrounding that is causing her discomfort, that is causing her unrest, everything that she's wrestling with in her surrounding, we release the blood of Jesus in her surrounding right now. We release the hosts of heaven right now in her surrounding. Yes, God, we pray today, Almighty God, that you will release your peace in Julian's surrounding today. Father, we decree and declare that the gates of hell shall not prevail against Julian today. Father, we declare the lordship of Jesus Christ over Julian and over her surrounding right now. We command the peace of God to you, Julian. We speak peace in your situation. We speak peace, even the peace that passeth all understanding. And we release the blood to fight for you this morning. Father, we thank you that you said what we lose is loose and what we bound is bound. Therefore, Almighty God, I release, I lose your order in your life. I lose peace. And I thank you today, Almighty God, as Julian understand who you are and allow you to be king and ruler of her life. I thank you right now, God and King, as you rescue her from everything, Almighty God, that is causing her pain, in Jesus' name. Father, in the same breath, I pray for Barrington and family. Yes, God, I lift them up to you. And I thank you, Almighty God, that you are no respecter of person. But Father God, you said, whosoever will, Almighty God, believe on the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, they shall be saved. Saved from what? Saved from every miserable condition that plague mankind. And so I release salvation over that family right now. In Jesus' name, I thank you, Almighty God, as you intervene in these lives and as you change the order. I release the blood of Jesus right now to remedy this situation. And Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I pray that Barrington and his family will never be the same, in Jesus' name. Father, I lift up Michael and family to you today, God. You know them. You know everything that there is to be known about them. Nothing about them takes you by surprise. The situation in their life is not a surprise to you. It's not a surprise to anybody with your situation. Because, Father God, if it's one thing you did, you made preparation. And so, God, you know that Adam, in case Adam had fallen, you made preparation. And this preparation is already come. Jesus Christ, the darling son, came. And he gave up his life as a ransom that man might come back into your kingdom. And so this morning, Almighty God, the problem, the stress, the situation that are up against us, Almighty God, we know that it's because of the wicked devices of the enemy and the choices of mankind. But today, Almighty God, we superimpose your lordship. We superimpose your order over the life of Michael and family. We shut down everything that is against them, Almighty God. We shut down every evil that is spoken against them in the name of Christ the King. And Father God, we superimpose your order upon their lives now in Jesus' name. And we thank you, Lord God, as you forgive and as you have mercy and as you correct their situation. And as you, Almighty God, allow your order to fill their lives and bring them into the purpose that they were created for in Jesus' name.
The King changes. It changes everything. Dr. Penn.
Thank you.
Blessed by this ministry, we would like to give you the opportunity to partner with us and help us in sharing the cost to win the loss. To send your gift or offering, please call us at 583-4479 or email us at vsharpmiller@gmail.com.
Planning a party, club night out, stage show, a gospel concert, or even a business sales event? Let Styles FM be a part of your promoting tool. Take advantage of our low-priced promotion packages with commercials, interviews, giveaways, reviews, and much more. We have special offers when you mix and match and bundle your options. Contact us at 876-286-9216 or 439-5160. Styles FM, for the most effective way to exploit your marketing dollar.
Mr. Brown, the work material done, you know. What me fi do?
Check Robinson's and Sons Hardware, man. Them have everything you need and more. They are at 18 West Palm Avenue, Port Antonio, Portland. Paints, nails, doors, everything to meet your hardware needs and much more. Call them at 993-9763 or 382-6209 and email them at sandhardware@gmail.com.
Mr. Brown, me get everything we need quick and fast. Sure, maybe we could have just stopped the chatting so we could have done the work just as fast.
What was that, Johnny?
No, man. We just said Robinson and Son are going good.
Robinson's and Son's Hardware. We are always here to serve you.
Right Way One-on-One Pharmacy for the most affordable prices. We offer free blood pressure and sugar checks for hypertensive and diabetic patients on each prescription refill. Shop in comfort and experience a customer service which is second to none. Visit Right Way One-on-One Pharmacy, Royal Mall, Farmy Building, Port Antonio. Opening hours Mondays to Fridays, 8:30 a.m. to 6:30 p.m. and Saturdays, 9 a.m. to 6:30 p.m. Major credit, debit, and health cards accepted. Call us at 715-2109. That's 715-2109.
Relive the music memories. Solid Gold Style Sundays from 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. with your host, Captain Baker, on your favorite station, the Beeper Station. Styles FM 96.1. Reminisce on the past with the music. Flashback on what it is that was. It's a program you don't want to miss on a Sunday. Solid Gold Style from 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. You join me. Let us recap the music of yesteryear. Cool.
Live the best music experience.
Sunday Peppering on Stars FM 96.1. Sundays 8 to 12 midnight. To begin the work week, only on Stars FM.
In my royal ministry with Sister Victoria. Yes, the little head with the big voice. In cooperation with Kem presents a kingdom explosion with a royal gathering of the sons of God. Come sail away with us on a 4-day cruise to the Bahamas. From June the 6th to the 9th, 2016, where we will share in this event the message of the kingdom of God. For more information, just contact 583-4479 or 852-3611. For further details, call now. The spots are going.
Hi, this is Vonsail Belcher, and you're listening to Styles 96.1, 96.7, the People Station with Victoria Miller.
This is Lighting My World.
Yo, you better watch out for the hypocrites, them, you know. Yeah, man. And the parasites, you know. And the Jebusites, them, you know. Them not live right, you see it. Yo, Raphael, what you say?
Yeah, man, I show your talk. And that's why I listen to Sister Sharpie in the morning and Styles FM 96.1.
Losing a loved one can be a very difficult experience. At St. George's Funeral Home, we try to ease that burden. We offer 24-hour pickup island-wide, airport pickups and drop-offs, gospel bands, grief counseling, funeral clothing and accessories, headstones, custom and personalized packages. Visit us at 24 West Street, Port Antonio, and 22 St. George Street, Buff Bay, Portland. Call us at 913-6450 or 841-3117 and 715-4058. From the USA, Canada, and the UK, toll free 347-377-8126. Like us on Facebook, St. George's Funeral Home, or email us at stgeorgesfunhome@hotmail.com. St. George's Funeral Home, thoughtful and caring service when you need it most.
Indeed, yes, the program is brought to you by the St. George's Funeral Home. Yes, you know where to reach them. Remember, they are located at 24 West Street, Port Antonio, or 22 George Street, Buff Bay. If you want to reach them again, the number is 913-6450 or 841-3117 and 715-4058. You can also send them an email at stgeorgesfunhome@hotmail.com.
Me in the valley. Hide me from the rain.
This time we are going into the Word. We were in the segment of praise and worship and prayer requests. The third segment is now here. We go straight to the Word. But before we do, we want to pray for Megan, who is in the hospital. Doctor saying some stuff, but even now, our God is awesome.
He can move.
Can you believe it with me, sister? That God is so awesome. I mean, the other day we had this sister, she came in me, and she said she was, doctor was telling her about cancer and what in her body. She was from England, and she came to the fasting. And she returned the other day. I think it was sometime in December we saw her again, and she came back from England, and she said, you know, that when I went back and I went to the doctor, there was no sign, no trace of these cancer cells. They were gone. Hallelujah. Our God is awesome. And so this morning we declare it in the atmosphere. We declare it in your body. We declare the peace of Almighty God. And so, Father, we lift up Megan in the hospital right now, Almighty God. Every situation that has attacked Megan from whatever place or for whatever reason, we superimpose the blood of Jesus. We release the blood of Jesus right now on Megan's behalf. Yes, God, we cover Megan with the blood of Jesus. We use the blood as a remedy, as a source, as a defense against everything that is coming against her body and her life. That which she's placed into the earth to do, Almighty God, we pray, Almighty God, that as you heal Megan right now, she will come into the understanding. She will know, Almighty God, that you have done this thing for her, and she will be led to seek and to find out your kingdom. Father, I thank you right now as you allow your goodness to lead Megan to repentance. Superimpose your lordship over her life right now, Almighty God, and let your will be done. Let your kingdom come in her life and bring her wholeness in Jesus' name.
Oh!
Yes, indeed, our God is awesome. You see, when there is not even a word for us to express his name, to express his character, to express all of who he is. So we sum it up in one word and we said, awesome. Indeed, Almighty God, you are awesome and we just want to love on you today. Yes, we have been looking on the topic, discovering the kingdom of God through Acts, the book of Acts. Now, last week I stopped at a particular place in my teaching, and I'm going to be picking up from there because we are looking at discovering the kingdom through the book of Acts. What we are doing, we are examining Acts closely to look at the way that the church of Acts function, and we are also looking at today's church, the present church that is now in the earth, because remember, God gave his son to the world, and the son gave the church to the world. So the representative on earth for the kingdom of God is the church. But we want to really examine closely what is the difference with the church of Acts compared today to the church that we are now living in, the present state of this church that is in our time. We want to see if they have lost it or they are still carrying that aroma, that message that Jesus Christ gave to them to carry. Or they are out of place and need to come back into place. Yes. Right now, last week we talked about some stuff. And we talk about persons who in this age and time, when we look at the church, how the way they function and the type of message that we hear in the church today, we said that people want itching ears. They do not endure sound doctrine where they sit and learn noiselessly. But instead, they want a kind of doctrine, or they want a kind of teaching that will entertain them. And so I said last week that the Bible has stated that in the last days, persons will not endure sound doctrine. And if you look in the church today and look at what is going on and the kind of message that is being preached, it's not the message of the kingdom. It's more like an entertainment realm. Persons just go to church to be entertained. And so if you have a good person who is representing the kingdom, that is going to teach people about the kingdom of God so they can come into it and function from it and see their life change, they will think that is boring. They will think that it is dead because they go to church to be entertained. But I have news for you this morning. How much of this kind of preaching or teaching change your life? Eh? And so we like when we go to church and it's something they hype up. And we say, yes, preach it. And we say all kind of something, and we don't sit and we just hyperactive and we hype up in our emotion by some message or some preacher bring. And we don't know how to sit quietly and learn. Right? And as a result, not changing our life, because all we have is entertainment. The kingdom of God exposes and supersedes false power. Simon was into witchcraft. Mm-hmm, that's where we stopped. Evil activity. And the whole town respected him because everybody was afraid of him. Like for the community today, sometimes when you're looking at the community, you know, you see some done man in there, and everybody respect them, and everybody love if you just heal them up and say, well, I'm boss and I pay a boss, and as I get to that, they're smarty there. And when you look at the caliber, when you look at why persons respect these persons, and everybody wants to be like them, especially the little youth them from the ghetto. Then see some man a drive up some big car and then say, yes, them man, they are done. Wrong concept. And these are the brainwash communities that we see. That is all brainwashed by witchcraft and jugglard and all of these gangster thing. And they impose it on the youth. And the youth look up to them and say, this is the kind of life I want. And some of you say yes. And some of these men influence these people to come and work for them. And in a nasty scheme, not understanding. And then send these little boys into drug trafficking and all of these things, you know. And when you take a stock, then go to prison. And you wonder how some of them endure and last so long in it. Simple. They are in witchcraft. They're not just so. So you see them and say, me want to be like them. And you go and work for them and not understand what they're in. Because they're not just so. They are highly involved in activity of evil. That's what they used to stay into it. And then say, them themselves now go. But because you have this dream to be like them, before you understand everything and where it are gone, without understanding so them maniac wrap up in a witchcraft, you're gone because you try to be like them. And not before long your little light out. You know, get it. So here was this Simon who was in this community. And he was such a don in this community because his practice was witchcraft. And the Bible tells us that he had the whole community bewitched. It's like he put a spell on them. And that exactly go on with the people them in these jugs thing too. Because everybody worship them and call them don. Yeah. And then bewitch the little youth them. And that's what the same Simon is doing here. Simon was into witchcraft, evil activity, and the old town respected him because everybody was afraid of him. But let me tell you this, witchcraft powers have no effect on kingdom citizens. Yes. There's not a witchcraft, but when you understand who you is in God, yes, when you understand what you are about and who you represent, when you understand that the greater one lives on the inside of you, then witchcraft powers is no match for you. When witchcraft people come in your face and try a thing with you and do something, them bunks off, then can't stick because the greater one lives inside of you. And it is not going to not affect you because you don't know that the greater one lives inside of you. You have to know who you are. Yes, that's how it works. No, don't laugh at Simon. Yes, don't laugh at Simon. Why? It's a very important man. Simon teaches us some things in the Bible. Yeah, Simon represents all of us. What did Simon want? Power. And that's what we all seek for today in our life, everyday life. All of us seeks to be in control of our everyday life. All of us want to have control of our situation and our circumstances. All of us want to have control of our day. So all of us seeks for power. It's the same thing Simon was seeking for, but instead he was in witchcraft. This was the way he seeks it, right? But the main reason why he was in witchcraft is because he wanted power. Somehow we not use witchcraft, we use other things, yes. But nevertheless, all of us is like Simon. We all want control over our lives again. And that's why you read horoscope, you call people to read your palm. You give big offering in a church saying, say, if you sow a seed, you will get back something. Because this is some of the religious teachings that persons give out to allow persons to think that God is there to be appeased. And so we do all of this with one mindset in mind, to have control of our lives again. Everybody, no, make them fool you. Every jack, man, boy, girl, woman, man, and everybody, they all want control of their lives again. And that is why they join church. That is why they go into certain religion. That is why they go into certain things, because they want power. Yes. every one of us want power. Why is that power drive there? It is inbuilt. We were made with it. And so, we do all these stuff to gain back power to our lives. So the kingdom was where God created man to rule in, to share in his government on earth. Any place where evil is reigning, it means that the kingdom principles are overrided by religion. And that is why evil reign. If you call yourself a born-again Christian, and evil continue to reign over your life and have dominion over you, it means that you are not fully embracing your sonship. There is religion someplace in your life. Because where the kingdom authority stands, you know, evil or witchcraft or none of these powers have any reign or rule over this person or even the ministry. So if you are a ministry or a person that is override and bombarded by evil, and evil is getting away with a whole lot of stuff in your life, then you need to check why evil is so rampant, why evil is so much in your life, because this is why religion is too high. We have forgotten the protocols of kingdom, because when the protocols of kingdom is upheld and the order is there, then evil have no reign and rule over that community, over that ministry, over that person. So religion is somewhere. Examine it. Yeah, that's how it works. So evil have no reign over anybody or any ministry or any community that the kingdom order is in fully. Yeah. Any place where evil is reigning, it means that the kingdom principle are overrided by religion, and that's why evil reign. It's not because God allow it why it reign. Because he says, what you bind, I will bind. And what you allow, I will loose. I will allow. Yes. So we have allowed evil to reign by allowing religious thinking. And we are glued to our traditional ways. Hence, we see the kingdom is powerless to affect the evil in our midst. So that's why evil have so much rights to us. That is why evil has dominated our lives so much, because our tradition is more higher. Our religion, our culture of religion is higher than the practice and the principles and the protocols of the kingdom in our lives. Now, until we become serious about divorcing our religious thinking, until we become serious about divorce in our religions and our tradition, then evil will prevail in our midst. Our prayers and declaration cannot substitute the principles of the kingdom or its protocol. So pray till you're blue. Declare something over your life till you're blue. If you don't insist that I'm going to come back in the kingdom order to follow the protocols and the principles of this kingdom that you have been born again into, then your declaration and your prayer can't substitute that. It won't change anything. That's just simple how the kingdom function. Simple. Religion was around when Philip went into Samaria. Yes, the scribe and the Pharisees was there. But yet still we hear the scripture says that the people were bewitched by Simon the sorcerer. Yeah, the church that in the community then where people are get turned down. Yeah, a whole heap of church in Jamaica. But look at what is going on now. Look at what is happening. Why? Because the kingdom have no effect in religious settings. And that is why people perish. Yes. The kingdom order is missing from these, what we call so-called churches. Now, sorcery have to do with demons and witchcraft. It have to do with magic and spells, portion, and you name it. Everybody dear respected Simon, and he was the don of that community, and he have that city locked with sorcery, and yet still religion was there. Churches were there. I wonder if you know the church is being mocked right now by some Obia man. They laugh off of you because you're ignorant about the truth of the kingdom that you come into. And as a result, they come and they have a head in your midst. They lock down the church. They come all among you and you promote them and give them deacon. You promote them and give them bishop. Then they laugh. The devil mock. It's a mockery where the church is concerned. Because you are operating from your religious ethics. And as a result, you can't discern. Because the kingdom of God in your life cannot do anything among you. And as a result, you lay dormant. And all kind of witchcraft and sorcery come among you and make bed among you and you promote them. Why? Because the kingdom order is missing from your ministry. That's why it happened. Mm-hmm. Like some of the garrison community here in Jamaica, a lot of churches are there, but religion is the order of these churches. Religious protocols are the only protocols they observe and follow. Yes, for when Philip showed up with the kingdom in Samaria, every other powers bowed to the lordship of Christ in Philip. You think if it didn't go on as a religious man, nobody would have get ill? Religious people already in a Samaria. The Pharisees were there. The scribes were there. But yet still the scripture teach us that the Philip bewitched the whole community. Yeah. But when the kingdom of God shows up in a person's life, what the kingdom is? The kingdom is power. Hallelujah. Simon thought he had power until he met Philip. Hallelujah. Simon saw such great demonstration of the power of God that he become converted. How many of us know a convert the other man and them and the barnyard and the mother people them around you in a community? Are they being converted? No! Instead, they laugh off on and mock and jeer on every day. Why? Because of your religious settings. Nobody's being changed. Your very congregation, people's lives have been torn apart with witchcraft and sorcery. And you're not even smelly. Much less for discerning. Because your operation is in religion. Let me tell you something. When kingdom is not present, evil is dominant. Evil is very dominant in a church where the kingdom is not present. Evil is dominant in a believer's life where the kingdom is not present. Evil is dominant because what? People who claims to be born again lack the knowledge of who they are as a son of God, and they go about being a servant of Christianity. They see God as higher than themselves. They see Jesus Christ as higher than themselves because this is what the doctrine teaches them. And as a result, look up to the very devil higher than them. They're afraid like puss. But do we remember when Jesus cast out the demon from the body? From the boy, what did the Pharisees say? And these were religious people talking now. What did they say? They said he did this through Beelzebub, who is the Lord of Flies. He's the chief of demons. That's what Beelzebub mean. Jesus, who was a darling son of God, he came into earth. And remember now, he's not from earth. The man Jesus may be from earth, but the Christ that is now living on the inside of Jesus was the one who was displaying all of heaven's culture in the earth. So he had power over all these things. And when he demonstrated, the religious folks look at him and say, look here, I buy Beelzebub, you do that. Mm-hmm. Now all this time, the boy was possessed for years. And church people was around him. And none of them could help him. Like when me hear some people say, boy, me carry my fasting, me carry my church, me carry me so me carry him this. Boy, me don't know if he do again, me just have to go find somewhere else and carry him. Like that. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. The boy was always there possessed with demon, and church people, religious church folks was always there. But when Jesus came, hallelujah, when power came from another realm, when the kingdom of God showed up, you see, the enemy is not afraid of religion. He's not afraid of religion, because religion dead, religion powerless. But when the authority show up from another kingdom, who have all authority that is given unto Jesus Christ, when he shows up in the earth with the authority and the power of the kingdom of God in him, really, guess what? That demon have to come out of that boy. Yes. All this time the boy was there sick. My God, no parents, no where else to carry him. But at the same time, when Jesus come and cast him out, religious people always are find fault. And so we stay up until today. When you find people like me, we stand up and do something, and you see power and demonstration coming from our lives. People out there so criticize we and say we no fi dip on radio because we no sound good. We can't cross with T's and we can't dot with I's and we can't talk English properly. And that is their thing because we are then setting at themselves. But guess what? I don't come here with eloquent speech. I come to demonstrate God. Because if God could have used you, then me would not have here, so. But because he can't use you because your religion stop him, that's why I have to take the best things of the earth. We're not going to watch no face. We're not have no education in our own institution. We're not pile up their mind to believe God and to allow God, the power of the Holy Spirit, to demonstrate through them. Thank God me never going to no colleges. Because probably if me did go to college, I wouldn't reason it out like everybody. I wouldn't have the time to allow God to rule through me. I wouldn't take me eloquence and my education and try to rationalize out God. But you can't fathom God. God bigger than your education. It's not about that. He said he will take the best things and shut up the wise and the prudence. Enough of no love talk. And now no life are nasty and stink and not changing there. And I don't put on a pretty clothes and pretty up on yourself and talk. But behind on a smile, there is a Lord Jesus Christ. On a life not ready. You need Jesus, the power from an eye to change you. But your religion stand up in your way. God Almighty help you. Look how Jesus answered these religious folks. He says, how can Satan cast out Satan? To really cast out Satan, it's going to take another power different from Satan to get rid of him. And some people don't understand the demonic realm. And they say, it can't happen. Because don't put it upon my family and me carry my other man and the other man. Get him off. You think I get him off. You go there with one dopey and you're left with more than one. Because he now cast him out. All him I got to do is give you one next dopey if you shut up that dopey there with upon your life. Don't be fooled. Because these persons not tell you the truth and they not tell you what they might do. Then just take your money and if you don't mind that, then we take your life and everything we have, we sacrifice to them for them to get power. They are liars. That is why you shouldn't go into their places because they not tell how they work. But you think, say, I get him off. When you're done, you end up with 3, 4, 5 dopey. And after a while, the one of them start fight again. Left you in a bigger trouble than before. So this is it. A greater than the devil is here. And he lives in me today. I represent that realm today. And I believe it. And because I believe it, I can see great manifestation coming out of my life. Jesus says, any kingdom divided by itself will not stand. Will not stand. Notice, did he use the word religion when he said any? You notice he never said any religion divided by itself? Because this was not a religious matter. Religion can't deal with them something, yeah. Simple. It takes a kingdom with dominion. Because you have to understand, say, even the devil have a kingdom. So when Jesus Christ came, he did not came in a religion. He came with an authority from another country to fight against this kingdom that was plaguing mankind. Notice he did not use the word religion. No, this have no dealing with religion. He's strictly kingdom dealing that he was talking about. In other words, he was saying, I see another kingdom have rulership over my citizens, and I free him. It's strictly governmental business, not a religion. So Jesus see a boy that was demon possessed who was a Jew. Now, does the Jew have any contract with the kingdom of God? Yes, they were contracted through Abraham. So when God show up, and because God sorry for him, make him heal him. And because Jesus sorry for this guy with demon possessed, he understand that this kingdom is not supposed to have rulership over this Jew, because him and Abraham have contract. And him come and see it. Even the woman when healing at the Sabbath day in the synagogue. You notice when he say, is she not a daughter of Abraham? So he not heal because he's sorry. He heal because a citizenship, and this citizen have a right to the healing. This citizen have a right to be free from every form of other control from any other government, any other kingdom. So Jesus quickly command that kingdom to loose that son of Abraham. But we in Christianity, we think say, we have to bawl and appease God and beg him, and we get emotional and we know it's not a rundown, and we say, oh God, you know, sister, me has suffer, God have mercy, and we think say, God, I go have pity, and we bawl and we bawl and we bawl. God not heal you because he's sorry for you. He will heal you if you are a citizen. Because citizens have rights. Bless the name of Jesus. Who are you today? Are you a citizen of the kingdom of heaven? Or you are just a member of a religion? You need to check it, you know. Because that is the biggest problem with us today. Then he closes his statement by saying, if I cast out this demon by the fingers of God, it means the kingdom of God is here. The kingdom of God is here. Where is the kingdom of God today? In heaven? As we wait to go there? While you are waiting to go to heaven, heaven is waiting to come here to you. Jesus prayed it. Jesus said, thy kingdom come where? On earth. How does it function? As it is in heaven. That's what he prayed. He said, when you pray, says, our Father, when the which art in heaven, holy is your name, and all of that. He said, thy kingdom come. When want your kingdom to come on earth? And he wanted to perform exactly as we perform in heaven. So you pray for God in heaven. And your destiny is heaven. And you believe, so you can't experience no life in earth, because the whole reason for salvation of go to heaven. Lie! Right here, right now, the kingdom come. And if you believe this and you are born again and believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, you are in the kingdom. So it means so you're in heaven. Hallelujah. But we get it wrong. We misinterpret it. You don't have to go to heaven to live life like you are in heaven. Because heaven have come to you. And this is what Christians don't know. Heaven have come to you. And so we teach people, say they must just hold on. No worry yourself. No live no life. Because you're going to live life when you go up. So right here, sign of the earth, heaven come. That's why Jesus came. Because what he came to do is to reinstate you to the kingdom that you had. When God put man in the earth, he said, have dominion. In other words, he was saying, have kingdom. Because dominion means kingdom. Have kingdom, right? He gave dominion to man. Man lost his kingdom. Man lost control. And as a result, we see man living in another kingdom. Jesus Christ came back to bring back that kingdom to man. So as many who receive Jesus Christ as the King of glory, the Christ, to them, he said, is given power to become not religion, not Christian, not Muslim, but sons of God. Sons of God. The kingdom attract those who are looking for power. I'll say that again. The kingdom attract those who are looking for power. Somehow we so wimpy. We just get saved and sit down and no power. We're not even filled with the Holy Spirit and we're not hungry for it. We don't care. And we expect we have control of our life again. You're not have no power. You don't have no power because you're not hungry for it. The kingdom attract those who are looking for power, like Simon. Notice him now? And that is why I'm in it. That's why I'm here in the kingdom. That's why religion couldn't hold me. Because when me go in it, me say, no, sir. This no feel like God. It no sound like the God where Moses did have. You know, it limited. Religion just limit you to a place. But me thank God for religion sometime because guess what? It launched me out into the kingdom. Yes. But when you're in it and if you stay in it, man, if you come to the understanding and the knowledge that there is more, and it's time for you to go to the next level and leave religion and come into your true identity as son of the Most High God. Yeah. Simon was real power hunter. Simon was a real power hunter. When he saw the power of the kingdom of God, he dumped the devil for the new power that he saw. Check out Simon. Simon, they really know. You might have seen Simon and everybody preaching a religion, say Simon this and Simon that. But really and truly, although Simon have the wrong concept, you know, the main reason why he do what he do is because he want power. He recognized the power in a Philip. And Simon was ready for divorce, even in witchcraft powers, for the higher power when he see it. Yeah, he dump the devil and get converted because of the power when he see a demonstrator of a Philip life. Now, the reason people ain't coming to God, it's because the options are choose between religion or the devil. Wow. Yes, and that's why people don't want God today. And I said they don't want God, you know. But the system what they see in the church is a religious system. And they don't want that system there. It too powerless, it too dead, it lifeless, nothing in it. And that is the options that are there, religion or the devil. As a result, nobody is coming. People are staying with the devil because religion is powerless. It makes slaves out of people. But when you meet the kingdom, man. You see, everybody when me tell so far about the kingdom, when I meet somebody and they ask me, what religion are you? And I said, I'm not from any religion. And they say, you're not Christian. I said, no, I'm not Christian. And when I begin to tell them about the kingdom, their face light up and then get excited. Everybody that I tell about the kingdom, even the Rasta man, they're ready for listening, ready for ear. Because when I tell them, say, look here, me no Christian man. This is what I believe. And they begin to listen. It begin to sound so appeasing to them. They're ready for ear. Everybody when we tell about the kingdom, their face light up. And they are ready to listen. Because Jesus Christ never brought back a religion and he's not a Christian. I can tell you that. mankind make that religion. So, when you meet the kingdom, you don't need anything else. The kingdom dominates the environment of the earth. The kingdom dominates the environments of the earth, like with the miracles that we see Jesus use. We call it miracle, but to Jesus that was natural because that's how the kingdom of heaven function. You know, get it? Everybody, I see them something there and I say, why Jesus worked such great miracle and everybody did after him, but that was natural for him. The kingdom where he was from, this is how they live life. Understand it. They speak to luck. They speak to poverty. They speak to demonic situation. No luck could exist in the presence of Jesus Christ because he was from heaven. So when Jesus walked on the water, healed the sick, raised the dead, we call them miracles. But this was how Jesus dominated the earth. And this was how Adam was supposed to live. When God said to Adam, have dominion, it means that none of these things would be able to rule over Adam. But because Adam lost his dominion, we see these things coming into play. But Jesus Christ came back on earth to demonstrate. So if you never know the power where Adam did have and who Adam did look like, look upon Jesus before him fall. Yeah, because the Bible called Jesus Christ the second Adam. If we know nothing about the first man, Adam, how he had dominion on earth, we can look at Jesus. Everything that Jesus did was what Adam could do and used to do. Adam used to walk by water too. Because remember, you know, God said to him, say, have dominion over the fish of the sea, the bird of the air. So Adam could do all that we see Jesus do. God says to Adam, have dominion. Adam stop having dominion when he falls to the deception of the enemy. When you are a kingdom citizen, you are supposed to have your need supply and never call it a miracle. Because that's what kingdom do. It takes care of its citizens. As a matter of fact, it is a miracle. If you are a true kingdom citizen and God don't take care of your need, that would be the miracle. Yes, it can happen. If you are a real kingdom citizen, then you are supposed to have your need supplied by the King of Heaven. In the kingdom, it's not enough to believe and reject the power. Because some of us, we said we are believers, but we don't want the power. We deny. The Bible says, having a form of godliness, we deny the power thereof. So we said the power is not for today. It's stopped with the apostles' lie. If you are a kingdom citizen, Jesus Christ himself said, behold, I give to you power. Yes, let's look at Acts 8 and verse 15 to 16. Verse 15 says, who, when they had come down, prayed for them that they might receive the Holy Ghost. So these are the other apostles. After Philip get them converted, they came to Samaria also, and they prayed for the people who were there, who receive, who believe and was converted and was baptized. The Bible said when these other apostles, if you look at verse 14, it said, now the apostles who were at Jerusalem heard that Samaria had received the word of God. They sent Peter and John to them, who, when they had come down, prayed for them that they might receive the Holy Spirit. And verse 16 said, for as yet he had not fallen on none of them. They had only been baptized in the name of Christ Jesus. So right there we see that one can be born again and still didn't receive power. And there is so much of us sitting in the church that is like that. in there for 40 years and still not receive no power. Wow, what a waste. So there's a difference between being born again and being filled or baptized with the Holy Spirit. There's a difference. Yeah. The kingdom of God is love, joy. Peace and righteousness. Where is all of this? The Bible said it's in the Holy Ghost. It's in the Holy Spirit. But Jesus believe. But just believing in Jesus Christ for salvation is not enough. It's not enough, man. You should go past that. Too much of you are sitting down in church comfortable where you are. Comfortable with your life the way it is. And that is why we have no need to find out who we are in the kingdom. We don't have no need to find out what kind of purpose we are there to fulfill. And so we sit down in there until we're dead and we claim so we are waiting to go home. If God didn't want you, it's just save and guide him the very minute he saves you and snatch you out of the earth. Yeah. But it's not about that. You have to believe for the power also. It's not just to believe for the salvation. It's not just to believe. Because look here, coming in to be a born again believer, you know, that is just the access for the power of God in your life. And the reason why you get this access is to allow the power of God to come in your life again. It's to restore you to the kingdom of God and the benefit of the kingdom. So you not just get born again for just stay dormant and sit down in yourself and wait for go to heaven. That's not the reason why you are born again. You are given, it's like you were activated for something. Yes, you get access to the kingdom through believing on Jesus Christ, but you don't stop there. You now need to go further and believe that there is a power that is given to you for you to come into the fulfillment of who God created you to fulfill. Yes. So you know, just stop a born again. You have to believe now. Again, you have to go believe for the power of the Holy Spirit that is supposed to fill you. These people believe in Jesus Christ for salvation and was born again and baptized into water. And there is a lot of us like that in the church. We love God, but there is no power in our lives because we have no open up. We have not opened up ourselves to the rest of the kingdom abilities. Yes, we sit in church for 20, 30 years, dormant, powerless. Every day when we want somebody to pray for we. We don't think we can pray for ourselves and see nothing change. You know why? Because you don't have no power. You don't have no power. There is no power in your life because you have not opened up yourself to the rest of the kingdom ability. Going to church and going through ritual is not enough for God. You need power to make impact. You need power to deal with darkness and diseases and sickness. You need power to cast out the devils and to raise the dead. All of that is going to take the power of God that is given. So I don't just come in and stop and say, me all right now, come born again. No, you need to go beyond. Devil will lick you off of your rhythm. Singing hymns ain't enough for God. And that's why today, if you are listening to me this morning, you can be baptized today with the Holy Spirit. Yes, I release the person of the Holy Spirit right now to every person who believes that you're a born again son and you have been in that position too long. I release the Spirit of God to fill your life today, to baptize you even afresh. Freshness, I release it today. And if you believe in that power right now, you can be baptized with the person of the Holy Spirit and even get a rebaptism. Yes, it's necessary to receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit to function effectively on earth. You cannot represent him without this baptism of the Holy Spirit. And that is why we see so much wimpy believers. That is why we see so much wimpy sons. because they are not hungry for this power. They don't want it. But look at Philip. Right now I'm going to be looking on the kingdom is not for sale. Yeah. The desire for power is the nature of all man. Now when Simon see Philip displaying the power, he says to himself, I want that power. No, was Simon born again? Yes, the Bible tells us. The scripture tells us that he was converted. He believed. Yes, he was born again. The scripture states that he was. He saw the power but didn't know the secret of this power. So he approached it from his concept of receiving power. What he had before was the witchcraft powers. How did he get the witchcraft power? He had to pay money to buy the books them and sit down and study them. And so that was the concept in Simon's mind. Maybe them a lay hand upon people and none a lay upon him too. Because when you go into a place, you know, and the Holy Spirit permit you now to lay on a person to receive the Holy Spirit, it's not everybody have to lay on, you know. Because once you lay hands on a few that are dear, once they receive the Holy Spirit, after you left, you, them can't lay on upon the others. Because that's how it is. So hands need to lay upon everybody. So probably Simon, hands were not laid on him. And so he had it in his mind that it was only through these men, these high authorities that came down, the apostle, that he could have received this power. So maybe when the hand lay upon him, he said, no, man, me have to go bribe them and I have to lay on upon me too. Yeah, because that's how we receive his witchcraft power, by money. So what was in his mind. That was what he knew. His mind was not yet renewed. So though he was born again, his mind was not renewed to God's way of receiving this power. He did not understand it. And like a lot of us today, that is why we continue in religion. Because we read the Bible out of religious concept. We read the Bible out of our own mindset. We don't see the scriptures of God through the eyes of God. We see it from our own understanding. And as a result, we don't understand fully what God is saying. It's like God is giving us a message, you know. God is saying something, but we misinterpret the message we're going to give because of how we understand things. And as a result, we don't get the message properly. That it's the same thing with Philip. He did not understand this kind of power. He did not understand the secret to this kind of power. And so he bribed the apostles, like many of us today. His culture was to pay money and buy witchcraft books. And that is what we can't. Or we won't renew our mind from the way we know things. We follow traditions of our elders. So it was Simon's tradition. Yeah, for by power. So he approached the kingdom of God the same way. And as a result, he couldn't receive it. So let us look at verse 18. Verse 18 said, now when Simon saw that the Holy Spirit was given through the laying of hands on the apostles, of the apostles' hands, he offered them money. Offered them money. And verse 19 said, saying, give me also this power that whoever I lay my hands on may receive the Holy Spirit. And verse 20 said, but Peter said to him, may your silver perish with you because you thought you could obtain the gift of God with money. Right? That's what Peter says to him, because in concept never right. Eh? So the mind frame they want renew. Many of us mind frame want renew today about something, man. Not just witchcraft. A whole lot of tradition where we're still stuck in. A whole lot of culture where we grew up in. We want to take them off and renew our mind. And at the same place, at the same way we approach God with from our tradition. Yeah. Like Simon. Now, how many of us want God's power to show off? Because at that we see church people, though, we show off with the power of God. God will not entertain people. He will not. God is not for entertainment. And that's why I'm not even into concerts. Styles of their concert here, yes, and I will have to support it because I'm a member here. I works here, and that's why I support it from ear to ear. But how many life do you see transform in a concert? People just go there to feel good. People just go there to have a good time. God, it's not about that. You don't understand the intensity of sin, you know. So people are dead. Devil are kill people from lies. Persons are being marred every day. When you understand what is going on around, you don't have time to play or entertain. Because people are dying. Lives are being destroyed. It's not time to play. It's not time to be entertained. It's time to seek and to save those who are lost. We don't understand the power of sin upon people's life, you know. Else we wouldn't play with sin. We're born again neither. We don't even go back and wrap up in our sin. If we don't understand the power of sin. We don't play with sin. We don't look for excuse for sin. We don't do all kind of something with sin same way. And we don't wonder why things now work. Because we don't desire to live sin. And as a result, we don't just go through the motion. And let me tell you, no time for play. Me no bother with playing. Me no do it. God will not entertain people. God is not into show business. Me can't tell you that. So if you want him power just for entertain, if you want him power just people for see, say you have this and you have that, God no in that. That's not what he's about. And there are many ministries today who are simple, massive entertainment ministries. That's all they do. People go not to be changed. They go to watch. Yes. And so somehow we, the reason why we left we place, look here, we, if we hear now, you have a lot of religious people. If we hear right now, say Benny in their town arena, everybody buy them bus ticket and everybody buy PFE bus and charter, all of them gone over there. And then now go for change their life and catch you, know, and for heal people like Benny, you know. No. Them a go fi see who a get healing and where them a get. So it's all about a watch thing. It's being entertained. You see Miles Monroe, there's a lot of time when he fly down into Jamaica and preach the kingdom in a Jamaica. And they no catchy. They no catchy. They don't go say, ah, you might the kingdom preacher and sound good. They don't catch it. And it's not about watching. It's about catching it and doing it. That is why our life is so bombarded with all kind of hypocrisy in it. Because we are more about entertainment. We just want to be entertained. Life now slap you good. Because anytime it starts slap you, you're going to seek God and seek him like how you have to seek him and understand sin of a play with sin. You see, Jesus told the people who just wanted to see sign and wonders. And he called them a wicked and adulterous generation. He said it is a wicked and adulterous generation that seek after sign. And so we stay. We just want to find out. Who did get healing? You did see the boy? You did see this? And that's all we go for. We not go for catchy. And so Simon have the right motive, but the wrong concept. The only reason we should want God power is to serve and fulfill his will in your life. That's the only reason. Any other reason behind that, he will not grant this power. Any other reason is idolatry. People are using fake power right now in the church. And then do some trick. And some something a go on in a church. Do you think that easy? You see, when you don't have the power, you are going to manufacture it. And people are falling by the thousand to divination and fraud. It's all a deception. Let's look at the kingdom of the heart. Kingdom of the heart. Corruption begins in the mind, which is what God called the heart. Let's look at verse 20 to 23. But Peter said to him, may your silver perish with you, because you thought you could obtain the gift of God with money. You have neither part nor lot in this matter, for your heart isn't right before God. That's what Peter says to Simon. You will not get this power. When he says you don't have neither part nor lot, he said this power will not be given to you because of your concept. Yeah. Right? So this is it. He said, repent therefore of this, your wickedness, and ask God if perhaps the thought of your heart may be forgiven you. For I see that you are in the gall of bitterness and in the bondage of iniquity. So there was a bondage over his mind. Mm-hmm. This man offered money to get the power of God. He wanted the kingdom by bribe. And believe it was not. And believe me, today it has not stopped. We see people going on the same way. So the kingdom is of your heart. It can only affect a man through the mind. The kingdom can only start to affect you when you hear. The Bible says faith come by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Now the moment you hear something, where you do, it gets into your soulish realm, which by your mind, in your soul. Yeah. So, in order for Simon to experience the kingdom, he had to have a change of mind, a change of concept. He had to see things from God's point of view. You have to be in agreement with God. You have to come under his rulership to demonstrate his power. That's simple how it is. You don't go no other way. His power will not be granted to you. You can't use the Holy Spirit as you have a mind. You know, works. So. You will never display God for who he is under another rulership. And that is why we don't see the manifestation even in religions. Because if religion are the order of your church and the order of your day, you're going to have a dead church and people in the sick, dead, empty, and nothing not change. Let's look at Matthew 12:34. Verse 34 said, you offspring of viper, how can you, being evil, speak good things? For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So you see, what Simon have in his heart. The first word Jesus used was repent. Why? In order to experience the kingdom, that the first word he used when he come to earth. Let me read to 36 also. He said, for you, Matthew 12, mm-hmm. He said, for you, I tell you that every idle words that man speak, they will give account. I don't think I'm at the right place. The kingdom that he brought back. He brought it back to your mind, which is the heart, must be changed. So when he say repent, what he's saying is, in order for you to understand the kingdom clearly and what he really brought back, you have to change your way of thinking. Yes. You have to change the way you see things. The kingdom of God is a kingdom of the mind or the heart. That's what the Bible says. When it talks about the heart, it is really talking about the mind. When did this happen? When we have to depend on our sense realm to survive. So the question I'm asking here, when did man have to depend on their heart or their mind to receive the kingdom of God. If you don't understand the message of the kingdom of God, you cannot enter into the kingdom. So the question I'm asking, when did this start to happen to mankind? Where they have to receive the kingdom of God through their minds? When we started to depend on our sense realm to survive, that's when it started to happen. You know why? The Bible, if you notice clearly in Genesis, the Bible tells us that when man sin, man begin to look on himself and say, but men are naked. Why didn't man see that they were naked before? What, they were blind? It's not that they were blind. It's because of who was in rulership position at the time. Before man begin to rule from their sense realm, they were not open up to the sense realm. They were ruling from their spirituality. It was their spirit who was in leadership position. The spirit of the upper, and the spirit was the one who was set in the communication mode. Right? And so the spirit did not see himself naked because the body was the spirit's clothes. That is why the spirit did not see himself naked, because he was clothed by the body. Right? And so, because the spirit was the one who lead man at that point, then there was no need to say that he was naked, because his body was his clothing was his body. But the moment man fall to the deception of the enemy, the spirit was shut down. The sensual realm now, the eyes of our conscience, where we become conscious in our sensual realm, was now open. And so that was when we have to receive the kingdom now that was going to be taught to us in any part, if we were going to be educated. And that is why man have it so hard, you know, because they have to improvise now. They don't know nothing about the sense realm, because all along they live on earth, they were governed by their spirit. But the man eat the fruit and the spirit shut down. Man now have to govern by their sensuality. And so the body look and see itself naked. That is why. So it's possible to be saved but not converted. Yes. And this man was saved but not transformed. And that's why in the book of Romans 12, Paul say, be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Because if you don't get the word of the kingdom or the message of the kingdom into your mind, there can be no transformation taking place. And so, do we believe that it is only sin we can renew our minds about? No. It's not only sin that we can renew our minds about. God wants us to renew our minds from every other culture of man. And that's the only time you will see transformation taking place in your life. The change comes when we download his culture into our subconscious mind, which is the heart. Yes, we have a mind and we have a subconscious mind. So when we allow his culture to fill our subconscious mind, we will manifest God's kingdom in the earth. Now, how do we get things into our subconscious mind? We get things into our subconscious mind by repetition. Repetition. So if we play these things over and over and over again into our surrounding, get into our mind and then get into our subconscious mind. God is more concerned about mental revolution than religious rituals. Yes, he's more concerned about transforming your mind than you going through a bunch of rituals. God is more interested in changing your minds than changing your clothes. Because a lot of us are so eager to conform people to a certain dress code, and their attitude is not right. Yeah, so we conform them. And we make bishop out of them, and we just spit them out. So everybody a bishop and pastor and deacon nowadays. And look upon their life, they're sinful like what? All they have are just conform. conformity. When you preach the kingdom of God to them, it will change their mind, and it will change the way they look and change the way they act. So it's not about changing and conforming to some religious rules. No. And that's what we see the church offer. The moment you get in these churches nowadays and give your life to Christ, people start telling you what their denomination believe in. And they use the denomination rule for culture you. So instead of renewing your mind to the word of God, you renew your mind to a set of religious culture. We don't really change nothing about you, because it's only the kingdom message that can change a man. When you preach the kingdom of God to them, it will change their mind. And after the mind is changed, you will see the very way they look change and the way they hack. Because in order for man to change, the change must first come in their mind. And that is why it is so impossible to trust people now, because they look so religiously genuine and generous in their dress code. But in their action and their attitude, them is a wretch. I've seen it. Pastor, evangelist, all of these people where we see, their minds need to be changed. And that's why some of us are fleshy. And full up of fornication and adultery. And live all kind of foolishness, fleshy life. And say, me can't change. You can't change. When the word of God comes to you and you meditate upon it, it changes you. Don't tell me no foolishness. Because Jesus Christ did not give his life so you can continue to wrap up in a sin. Sin destroys. You do all kind of find all kind of excuse. And on the talk so hypocrisy and talk about say, well, me not perfect. You are perfect. God makes his son to die for you to bring you into perfection. Grace did not come so you could continue in sin. It comes for you to be perfect. And you can be. The word of God says you must be holy. And he makes that available for every man who will receive this Christ. It is the Christ in you that will make you stand. But because your mind is not transformed with the kingdom message, and it's just a conformity that you takes on, nobody can be entrusted to you. You can't even entrust your pitney them to the preacher them again, because you let them in them present them a rape boy and girl. What a church. All because their minds have not been renewed. Yes, I said it. Radio. The church need to look at the church of Acts. It need to understand who the church of Acts represent. It was not Christianity that they call themselves. My God, they did not have a conformity thing. They had the power from an eye. They had the person of the Holy Spirit. The Christ was on the inside of these people. And because of that Christ that they carry, they were able to dispense power. And they did not wrap up in sin because they were changed from their minds. Hallelujah. How much of you want to continue in the place where you are? You just want to continue happy-go-lucky and live any old life and call yourself Christian and say, but nobody not perfect. If God not come to bring you perfection, then they not come to bring you nothing. Because if what Jesus did on the cross what's for you to continue to live your life, then that makes sense in it come. You need to embrace your sonship. Believe what the word says. When you believe it, you will live it. There's no other way. But you don't believe. Because number one, the word is not even being taught to you. All that is upheld is your denominational rules. And as long as you go by them, you live nasty and dirty like everybody else. Look here, it's time for the church to be the church, man. Enough is enough. Somebody sent me a text the other day, and they were saying, pray, 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 because the church in India, the church in India is in trouble because Muslim attack and all kind of terrorist attack is against the church. I'm trying to find that text. And I responded to the person. This person may have think I was cold, but I was not cold. It's not that I was cold why I responded the way I responded. Right? Let me find the text. It said, urgent prayer request for the church in India. Buddhist extremists in India burned down 20 churches last night. Tonight, want to destroy more than 200 churches in Olisabang province. They want to kill 200 missionaries within the next 24 hours. All Christians are hiding in villages. Pray for them and send this message to all Christians you know. Ask God to have mercy on our brothers and sisters in India. When you receive this message, please urgently send it to another Christian. I responded. I said, how much longer will the church be Christian? You see, as long as they remain Christian, these things will continue to be. These things will continue to be. But it is time for the church to embrace their citizenship of the kingdom of heaven. Only then will they have real power. And the only message that can bring this change is the message of the kingdom, not the system of Christianity. I love the church, but I hate the system of Christianity. I can only pray that those who are born again and call themselves Christian will find their true identity. So the kingdom message can never. So the kingdom message can cover the earth and then the end to all these madness will come. How we make these things still continue? Because what? We fail to preach the message of the kingdom. The message that we give to the people of the church today. It's not the message of the kingdom. If you listen to it, my God, we more preach the effect of the kingdom than the kingdom message. We preach what Jesus did. And we go there and we make a sermon just from one little event. Jesus was at the pool of Bethsaida, at the pool, where he healed the man with the and tell him to take up his bed and walk. And people make a sermon out of this. And Jesus said, the man was at the pool, and he said, take up your bed and walk. Is there anybody who have a bed today? And we sit and sitting here up and down with the vice and all both. And all now, the message of the kingdom has not been preached. Why? Because you don't know how Jesus performed that miracle. You need to get it. Learn it, understand it so you can do it. Because if you are going to change earth, you must have power. God never expect we to be wimpy Christians. We said we are sons of God. We are called out. We are set apart. We are a light that is supposed to be on a hill, that's supposed to give light to the world. It means that we are going to be testimony to people. How can we testify in this world that we are living in without power? We wrap up and we crawl up in and we mix up in all kind of foolishness. God want the church to be the church. And the only message that can bring this change is the message of the kingdom. Stop preaching what Jesus did and preach about the kingdom. What was the kingdom like? How do man get into the kingdom? When they get into the kingdom, how do you function into the kingdom? When you start to function into the kingdom, what are the manifestation? We need to know these things. It's not just to preach Jesus who dies. It is to preach the kingdom. Jesus never tell any single one of us to preach me. No, because you're not getting it. It's not so much the Jesus, but it's the Christ. He said, preach this message. Because he knows that it is only the message of God is going to get people to come out of their foolishness. But we run with it. And we preach about Calvary. And we preach every other message except the kingdom. What does the kingdom offer? The kingdom offer back man their dominion. What does man use dominion for? To control their lives again. How does man get these dominions? Through the person of the Holy Spirit. Who is the person of the... Look here. We don't teach these things. We talk about them. And we talk about what we see Jesus do. But do you catch it? Because Jesus never intend you to preach what we do. Preach about what the kingdom have to offer, man. It's like going to America. So many persons want to live in America today. Why? There's a more opportunity today. You know how much opportunity in our kingdom? You know how much freedom in our kingdom? You know how to get the opportunity to the kingdom? You know how to get the benefits of the kingdom? That's what Jesus wants us to preach. And stop preach what Jesus did. Because it's not so much what Jesus did. It's how much you can be like Jesus and also do. But you can't do them if you don't know. So it's not about going to church. And when I go to church and preach the kingdom, you have some people that fall asleep. You know what? They're not youth then kind of preaching there. Then youth is up and down, whooping and carrying on and being entertained. And then go home and say, church is nice today. But when me come and I teach you know how to function in the kingdom, you're not getting it. Because you're not used to it. You know why? In our itchy ears. So we give more attention to itching ears doctrine. Ticklish. Something will tickle your mind and make you laugh and feel good in your emotion. Lie. Because if you don't know how to function into the kingdom of God and see the kingdom manifesting from your life, situation are going to slap you down. And when situation slap, we say, the will of God lies. It's not the will of God. It's because you don't know how to function. You are conformed to religion. But you need to be transformed and allow your mind to be renewed with the kingdom message of God's word. Yes, that's the only thing that can really change a man. And until we get this message, Jesus Christ now put back in appearance in our earth. And that is why I not come yet. Because I know the church have not preached the message of the kingdom. The early church started it. And they demonstrated it effectively. But ever since we conformed to Christianity, we have been a dragging. But the church need to find their true identity in Christ and arise. I pray today that the church will be revived because it is the church that needs the revival. When the church is revived and when the church come back into their identity, then the world can be saved. The world can do better than what they might do because we who are called the light, we not shine. We wrap up in all kind of something like them. And as a result, the world is perishing. The world need the church, but right now the church lost. I pray that the church will come back into all its morals of who you are and manifest the kingdom of God in the earth and make Jesus Christ come. God bless you today. I hope you were enlightened. My message is not finished, but of course it's a series, so I'll take it again next week. Walk good. It was a pleasure being with you. Have a good day.
Thank you for allowing me to see myself the way you see me. Thank you.